Good evening and Merry Christmas. We would like to welcome everyone to St. Robert Bellarmine Parish as we celebrate the solemnity of our Lord's birth. We invite you to join together in giving thanks to our God for the gift of His Son who dwells among us. Our celebration this evening will begin with the solemn proclamation of the birth of Christ. Following the proclamation, we ask that you join in singing, "O Come, All Ye Faithful," which is found in the We Celebrate hymnal number 529. We will sing verses 1, 2, and 3, followed by verse 1 in Latin. "O Come, All Ye Faithful," number 529 in the We Celebrate hymnal. Please stand.
Thank you. God of every nation and people, from the very beginning of creation, you have made manifest your love. When our need for a Savior was great, you sent your Son to be born of the Virgin Mary. To our lives, he brings joy and peace, justice, mercy, and love. Lord, bless all who look upon this manger. May it remind us of the humble birth of Jesus, and raise up our thoughts to him who is God with us and Savior of all, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Forgive us our
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
His dominion is vast and forever peaceful.
from David's throne and over his kingdom, when he confirms and sustains by judgment and justice, both now and forever. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We started singing our response to God's word, "Today is born our Savior," which is found on the blue insert number 25.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to Titus. Beloved, the grace of God has appeared, saving all and training us to reject godless ways and worldly desires, and to live temperately, justly, and devoutly in this age, as we await the blessed hope, the appearance of the glory of our great God and Savior, Jesus Christ, who gave himself for us to deliver us from all lawlessness and to cleanse for himself a people as his own, eager to do what is good. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Swaddling clothes and lying in a manger.
And suddenly there was a multitude of the heavenly host with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests." The Gospel of the Lord. Merry Christmas, everyone. We're happy to have with us Father Andy Sinnott with us here on behalf of Father Andy and myself. We wish all of you blessings on this beautiful night that we gather to celebrate the birth of our Savior, Pope Francis in Rome, celebrating the Mass at night. Spoke about the littleness of the baby lying in the manger, as we heard in this gospel according to Luke, for the Mass at night. Wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in the manger, he spoke about the littleness of the baby over 2,000 years ago in Bethlehem. As we're told, they went out according to the decree of Caesar Augustus that everyone had to be enrolled. And so Joseph took Mary and they went. And we know the story. As the story was told, there was no room for them in the inn, so they found them lying in a manger, along with the animals and the hay, and the baby laid in the trough, where the animals would feed, and the baby was placed there in the manger, wrapped in swaddling clothes. And the Holy Father spoke of the littleness of God that came down to earth in the form of the baby lying in the manger, which becomes the grandest and the greatest to the world, the greatest act of love for all of us, our Savior, who is Christ the Lord. Isaiah said in the first reading, "The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. We pierce through the darkness of this night, only to allow the light that shines around us to burn brightly before us. When the fullness of light is revealed in the person of Jesus, who is the light of the world, who is the Prince of Peace, the one who brings to us justice, joy, mercy, and above all, love, that we live and share with each other. The littleness of God becomes the greatest for all of us." But the Pope said that oftentimes we have it reversed in our lives. We start out to be the greatest to the smallest. And it doesn't work that way with God. We start out in the littleness of the things of life to become the greatest for us in the way that we live out our faith and in the way that we live out our lives each day. That's what brings us joy. That's what brings us peace. That's what brings us mercy. That's what brings us justice. And above all, that's what brings us love. For that is what Christmas is all about. Christmas that allows us to share and to give to each other a little bit of ourselves, isn't it? By the sharing of gifts, the sharing of Christmas meals and gatherings, the presence of family coming together, to be able to share and to give of ourselves as God has given to us in the person of the Savior who came into the world to redeem and save us. This is the celebration of our salvation. And so, suddenly there was the multitude of the heavenly host with the angel praising God as we are here doing tonight and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to those in whom his favor rests." That, my friends, is you and me. Because Christmas can only come alive, the Christmas story can only be made real through you. That is how Christmas becomes real. That we can cry out to the world. The whole world cries out tonight and tomorrow what we are here celebrating in the littleness of God coming to us in the baby, but only to become the greatest of all in being our Savior and our Lord. And above all, leading us through life to the Father. This is our faith. This is our life. And this is the meaning of Christmas. And so as your pastor, I extend Christmas blessings to all of you and your families, our parishioners and friends of our parish. Blessings to all of you for a holy and blessed Christmas. And may the Savior, whose birth we celebrate within our families and our lives, be made real through the way we live out our lives each day, bringing joy and hope and justice and mercy and peace, and above all, love. Merry Christmas to you all. God bless you. Let us stand now and profess our faith. I believe in one God, Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us, down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate in the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father.
Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Today a Savior has been born for us. God's mercy made flesh. Let us rejoice as we pray for God's mercy upon the whole world.
Please respond to the Lord, hear our prayer. For the church, that our proclamation of Christ's birth to our world may bring hope and joy, peace and goodwill to all peoples. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For world leaders, that they may find in their hearts the will to sow justice and peace for their citizens and their neighbors, bringing wars, armed conflict, and abuse of human rights to a lasting end. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all our loved ones, that our exchange of gifts may be a sign of the joy we share of the presence of God's Son in our world. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all our prayers spoken and unspoken, for the sick and homebound, and for all those in our special attention book near our cross, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who struggle to find joy in the holiday, those who suffer from illness, loss, and hardship, that God's grace may find them in unexpected and tender ways, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us gathered here on this joyous day, that we may see the presence of Jesus in each other, in all whom we know, and in all whom we have yet to meet, that we may be blessed and blessing in the world, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for all who have died in Christ, for all the loved ones remembered on our Operation Christmas Tree this year, for whom this Mass is being offered, and for others we would like to remember, let us pray to the Lord.
God of wonder and glory, help us to incarnate your Son in our lives so that we can share your most precious gift with all whom we meet. Hear our prayers and grant them through your Son Emmanuel, God with us, whose coming we proclaim in joyous exultation through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Please join in singing the song during the preparation of the gifts, It Came Upon a Midnight Clear, which is found in the lead celebrant hymnal number 525.
Thank you.
sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice.
The blood of the new and eternal covenant,
which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
Look not on our sins, but
but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us share Christmas.
Thank you.
by the incarnation of his Son, has driven darkness from the world, and by that glorious birth has illumined this most holy night. Drive far from you the darkness of vice, and illumine your hearts with the light of virtue. Amen. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit descend upon you and remain with you forever and ever. Go forth, the Mass is ended. Merry Christmas, everyone. God bless you.
Thank you. mind of something, and then he does something. I think it was literature. He does something like, don't ask me. He's on late at night. It's on until 3, 4 o'clock in the morning sometimes.
Yeah, I've rarely seen him, and I didn't see him over there close for a while.
Yeah, no. It didn't bother him, it bothered me more. And he was doing, I mean, he basically kept his York, how many times?
Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas.
Good. Pass them out of it. Christmas to you.
Did you see my brother anymore?
I did.